Good afternoon, dear children.
How are you all?
You all are excellent. Yes, dear children. And we'll see if at home. We continue our last lecture. That is, I was teaching you lesson number seven from your grammar textbook. That is, finite kinds of verbs. In the kinds of verbs, yesterday in the last lecture, we have seen verb. What is verb? The definition of verbs we have seen. The helping verb, or we can say the auxiliary verb. That we have learned. Modals or modal auxiliaries we have learned. The fourth one we have learned, finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Now today we will learn the transitive and intransitive verb. So first we go to sixth one, that is the transitive verb. Transitive verbs that have object are called transitive verb. In the last lecture, I made you understand that subject, verb and object. In one sentence, there is always subject, verb and object. In some sentence, it is not compulsory to have an object always. So, in all the sentences, whenever you are finding the object in that sentence, that sentence is called a transitive verb. Okay, verbs that have object. What is meant by transitive verb? I repeat, transitive verbs that have object are called a transitive verb. Or the second definition that we can say, the action passes from the doer, means from the subject to the object. That is called, if that something is happened from subject to object, that is called transitive verbs. Okay, now that we will see here, verbs that have object are called transitive verbs. For example, in this example you will definitely come to know that I wrote with a pen. I wrote with a pen. So, wrote is a verb here, wrote. What you have written, I wrote. What wrote? With what? With the pen. So pen is your object. Here this is a verb. Transitive verb. All the transitive verbs in the sentence, they have an object. Understand? So here pen is an object here. Now second, Dino is reading a book. What is reading? Reading a book. So that is object. See, this is object. This is a verb. So transitive verb. This is called a transitive verb. Means what reading? Book is reading. What is writing with what? With the pen. Means the action passes from the subject, or we can say from the doer to the receiver. To the receiver. That is object. Okay. Now the or kicked. What he kicked? Kicked the football. Means he kicked. Who got the receiving that action? The football is. So this is object. So this is called a transitive verb. Neha studies English. Studies. What studies? English studies. So that is object. Okay, transitive verb. They cross the street. They cross the street. Again here you can find object. Okay, so that is an object, means a transitive verb. Rajat killed the tiger. Rajat killed. What he killed? Getting. That subject is getting the receiver. Doer is doing something and the object is getting. That is an action. That receiver. The doer, the action passes from the doer to the receiver. To the receiver. That is object. So these sentences are called transitive verbs. Like these verbs are called transitive verbs. Now we'll see intransitive verbs.
We'll see intransitive verb. Intransitive verb, exactly opposite of transitive verb. Intransitive verbs that don't have, you know, do not have objects are called intransitive verbs. Do not have object is called intransitive verb. Or we can say doesn't have a direct object. Action, whatever actions we are doing, that receiver is not there, doesn't have a direct object to receive the action. Okay, means in short you can keep in mind, if in that sentence object is not there, in that sentence that is a intransitive verb. We see examples. I cried. Cried is a verb here. No action and nothing is there. Receiver is object is not here. So this is called the intransitive verb. So second, the children smile. The children smile. No object. Okay. So intransitive verb. Neha studies hard. Studies. Okay. No object. Last time when the intransitive verb you have says Neha studies English. What studies English? That was a transitive. Okay, but it is an intransitive because there is no object. I am here. So here also no object. Snow fell yesterday. Fell. There is no object. If I am saying over here, snow fell on the ground yesterday. On the ground. The ground, that will be the intransitive because object is there on the ground. That is object. But here nothing is there. Only snow fell yesterday. So that is intransitive verb. So here, dear children, we have completed our lesson. That is lesson number 4. Kinds of verbs. So in that we have learned the verbs. Action verb, we can say. Action verb is called a verb. Definition we have learned. We have learned the helping or auxiliary verbs. Is, am, are, where, has, had. That is auxiliary verbs. Modes or a model auxiliary verbs that they have seen. That is can, could, may, might, shall, should. That is models that we always use for permission, for ability, for humble request and suggestions and all that we always use model or a model auxiliaries. Finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Finite verbs is near the verbs, near to subject is called the finite verbs, and the non-finite verbs somewhere else in the sentence is a non-finite verbs. Transitive verbs, transitive that have an object in that sentence is a transitive verb, and intransitive verb, just now there is a verb that do not have objects, are called intransitive verbs. This is our lesson. So that is page number 25 to 29. Dear children, go through that lesson once again. Try to understand what I taught you. And if you are not getting, once again you can see the clip and solve these. Take page number 25 to 29 in the textbook itself with pencil. I hope you definitely have understood this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.